Students, today we will start scattering of light in human eye and colorful way. Scattering of light is a complex phenomena. Let us try to understand the idea of scattering. Do you know what happens to the free atom or molecule when it is exposed to certain frequency of light? Atoms or molecules which are exposed to light absorb light energy and emit some part of light energy in different direction. Atoms or molecules, when they are exposed to light, when they are kept in light, they absorb light energy and they emit some particles of light energy in different direction. They will send in different direction. This is basic process happens in scattering of light. The effect of light on a molecule or an atom depends on the size of atom or molecules. It depends upon size. If the size of a particle is small, it will be affected by higher frequency, the light, and vice versa. If it is small, it will affect with higher. If it is big, it will affect with smaller. Let us consider that a certain frequency of light is incident on an atom. If suppose this is an atom, on this atom, some light is reflected or some light is incident. Then the atom comes into vibration due to light. This atom will vibrate. This in turn releases or re-emits light in all direction. It will release or re-emit. Again it will emit. It will send light in directions. Okay. With different intensities. The intensity of light is the energy of light passing through unit area of plane. Taken normal to the refraction of propagation of light in 1 second. Let us consider the free atom or free molecule in somewhere in space. Light of certain frequency falls on the atom or molecule. This atom or molecule responds to light whenever the size of atom or molecules is comparable to the wavelength of light. If this condition is satisfied, the atom absorbs light and vibrates. Due to these vibrations, the atom re-emits a certain fraction of absorbed energy in all directions with different intensities. The re-emitted light is called scattered light, and the process of re-emission of light in all directions with different intensities is called scattering of light. On this atom, some light is passed. Okay, it is emitting light in all the direction. This emission is called scattered light. Okay. The atoms or molecules are called scattering center. This is called scattering center. Let us take the angle theta between incident light and direction in which the intensity of scattered light is observed. We call this angle as angle of scattering. It is experimentally observed that intensity of scattered light varies with angle of scattering. The intensity is maximum at 90 degrees angle of scattering. At 90 degrees angle, the intensity is maximum. That angle is called scattering. This is the reason for appearance of clear blue color when look at the sky in the direction perpendicular to the direction of sun rays. If our angle of view is changed, the intensity of blue color also changes. See, when you are seeing the sky in a perpendicular direction from the sun rays, you will appear the sun as a sky in a blue color. If you are changing the view, then the blue color also changes. Now you might have got a doubt, why scattering of lights give blue color only? Why can't it give other colors? Let us find out whether the scattering centers are responsible for the blue color of the sky. We know that our atmosphere contains different types of molecules and atoms, right? The reason for blue sky is due to molecules, nitrogen and oxygen, the sizes of these molecules are comparable to the wavelength of blue light. These molecules act as scattering center for scattering of blue light. In the sky, in the atmosphere, there are nitrogen and oxygen. Number of molecules are present. Yes, the size of molecules are comparable to wavelength of blue light. These two molecules wavelength is compared to blue light. That's what the reason the sky will appear in the blue color. Okay. Our atmosphere contains atoms and molecules of different sizes. According to their sizes, they are able to scatter different wavelengths of light. For example, the size of water molecule is greater than size of nitrogen or oxygen. It acts as a scattering center for other frequencies which are lower than frequency of blue light. If water molecule is greater than size of nitrogen or oxygen, the scattering center will act as a frequencies which are lower than that of blue light. On a hot day, due to the rise in temperature, water vapor enters into atmosphere, which leads to abundant presence of water molecules in the atmosphere. These water molecules scatter the color of other frequencies. All such colors of other frequencies reach your eye and the sky appears white. Okay, on the hot day, what is happening? The water vapor enters into the atmospheres, and due to the abundant presence of water molecules, they will scatter and they won't appear in blue. There will be other frequencies which are other than blue frequencies. So the sky will appear white. I think you understood. In the next class, we'll continue. Okay, thank you, students.